Hi. To begin, you will need a pan sort of like this one. This is okay, but preferably without it. It makes it easier. No pans like this. This is really hard to do whenever you are trying to remove and stick sticks on the Jolly Ranchers after they are melted. You'll need a bowl of Jolly Ranchers, much more than these, but I'm just showing you a couple of suckers today. You will need your bags, your sticks, and your ties that were provided for you. And we will begin. First, begin by covering your pan with a piece of parchment paper about this size. Make sure it fits all around so when it melts, it doesn't stick to the tray. And then you would want to stick your Jolly Ranchers. No particular color order, just however you feel necessary. You can do them like this, which will be a typical, just normal Jolly Rancher sucker. You can do them like this, which will be of circular. These are a little harder, so you might want to wait till you get the first ones down to do these, but they turn out pretty cool. And when they're warm, you can even, if they're warm enough, you can even swirl them so they look like lollipops. See, and then you do this, and you just choose whatever colors you want. So let me do this, and I'll show you what it's supposed to look like. This is about how your tray should look. Mine, I do a couple of inches in between each, and then a little bit from the side. See, the way I did this, I'm going to have to cut here to here before I stick my sticks in so I can stick them in these. So if you want, you can turn them this way and cut them another way, or just do less. But let me just tell you, the less you put on your tray, the longer it takes. So also, don't forget, when you stick your sticks in, try not to stick them in other or stick them diagonally because they don't look as presentable. You'll want to place your Jolly Ranchers either on the top or bottom rack. Just make sure if you put them on the bottom, they take just a couple of seconds or a minute even longer. So just keep that in mind. You will want to set your oven timer to about 8 minutes. But keep a very close eye on them because if they start to bubble, then you know it's time to take them out and even they might be getting ruined. Make sure and keep them very spaced out, and good luck, and we will see you in a minute. Okay, guys, mine's been in for 8 minutes, but because they're still bulky and not necessarily melted all the way, because the oven is just first being used, it's not as hot as it does after you start a couple batches, leave it in there for a couple of minutes. Eventually, it'll get hot enough where 8 minutes is perfect amount, maybe even less. Okay, it's been a couple minutes, like 1 or 2 minutes after the 8 minutes. They are perfectly not too thin, not too thick, not running together, so my mom's going to go ahead and pull them out for me. And we're going to walk over here. She's going to show you how to cut the parchment paper and stick the sticks in. Where are the scissors? There. The scissors over there, Mommy. Okay. She needs to kind of hurry up a little bit because the pan only stays hot enough for them to stay melted for a little while. So, and the more careful you are, the better, because if you move them too much, they wrinkle. So be careful about that. Also, get your sticks ready to decide what I'm doing over here with my hand. See how slowly she's cutting? And you can always reuse your parchment paper. Do not throw it away because it is reusable. So what we're going to do now is pull it off, this piece. The other piece stays on while it's hot. Stick them in as fast as you can and roll them like this. And you want to get at least to the second color, Mom. Mm-hmm. At least to the second color.
How about a swirl?
And here she's going to show you how to... See, that's a minor swirl. It's very nice. Going to look very good. And then there's the swirls in which you completely alter where your colors were, which are cool looking and tasty. Double the color, double the awesome. See, and I'm going to do a different kind of swirl here. I'm going to see when you have circular ones, these even look awesome. And once they've been sitting on the pan for more than a minute, they don't swirl as easily, so sometimes they chunk up, so sometimes you just can't swirl them.
You gotta do it quick.
So that is what they're supposed to look like when they're melted. Now, this is the finished product. You shall wrap them and then put a little cute little tie on them. And then just bring them to school and we will sell them all in like a day. Thanks, girls. Bye.